Welcome back to another week here at the TirolerInn. We are going to finish the flooring. So first things first, I need to prep this area in the corner. You can see I still have to take some of the insulation and old plaster out. And then over here, there's a couple more boards that I have to cut out. So let's get that going and then lay the last few boards. Okay, now that we have it all cleaned out, we will do some blocking over here, those three spots, and then behind me, underneath the cabinet, that joist is right underneath the cabinet. So what we're gonna do is we are adding some blocking slash a sister joist on the outside of this one, just nail it on there so that we have something to support the flooring all the way here into the corner. So when we're standing here, it doesn't just flex down.
Thank you. fully covered with a subfloor, and we were talking a little bit about our kitchen layout plans. So two options that we think would work well for us. One idea is to make this area our workspace and have a peninsula come out right here. And then this whole space is open to walk through. Another option is, the other option we were discussing was having an island here and being able to walk out on both sides and having that be our workspace back here. We want to keep most of the appliances back here, and most of the appliances maybe down in the cabinets as much as we can. All right, so I came over today and Emmanuel was showing me here that this area has a couple layers of flooring on it as well that have been added over time as the rest of the flooring was added on top in the other parts of the kitchen. So this tile was not original. He was thinking that this here was probably what was original, as the hearth was just a cement or stone block here. So what we probably will have to go ahead and do is take it out so that we can make it even with the rest of the floor, and then put some tile on as a new hearth, and maybe we can find some reclaimed tile or something nice to put on here.
So the next step here in the dining room area is getting this hearth cleaned up. What we'll do is we'll take it all out. There's multiple layers. I think Julie already explained it. So first, what I'm gonna do is take the old mantle off. We want to save it. We want to see if we want to use it, but we want to save that mantle. We also want to save all these tiles. So I'm going to take all of that stuff carefully off, and then I'll work on the hearth. So I found some more evidence of the floor changes over time. Basically here, you can see there is a little bit underneath the mantle of that same tile that is around the fireplace itself. And this is still sitting there. Obviously it's not very solid, but it is still sitting there with some grout behind it. So they clearly had at one point in time this tile everywhere around here, the entire hearth. Now that we removed all the concrete, bricks, and other mortar mixture that was in there, we now have to frame this up. We're gonna put a joist in here all the way close to the existing fireplace brick, and then we will put another one in parallel with the other joist. And we will also put a really small one over here on this side, just so we have something to sit on. So now that we have the framing in, we are going to put new subfloor on it. This is going to be much more stable when we want to tile over it. So new subfloor goes on top, covers up obviously this hole. We really don't need it. This was really for the concrete, so we don't really care. We're just going to floor right over it and we shouldn't have any issues. Yesterday was kind of a slow day at the construction site. Even though we finished the flooring, we didn't do much else, and that was because we were trying to figure out our kitchen slash pantry layout. We weren't 100% convinced if we wanted the door on the left side. We did a little bit of layout testing and we kind of established what we like and what we don't like so that we can move forward with the pantry door and the pantry wall next week. We can finish all of that, get a little bit of material that we're still missing, and then at least have a plan, a rough plan for our kitchen. I think this is it for this week. We finished the dining room floors where we had a little bit left. We took the hearth out and we replaced it with subflooring also. So I think this wraps up this project really well and I'm pretty happy. Now that we can move on to the next thing. I've gotten the question of what is next on the agenda, and well, we need to put up the pantry back where we had it before. Still put the walls up. We figured out kind of where exactly everything should be. So now the walls need to go back up. And then maybe first floor electrical is on the list also next. One thing that we have to do is upstairs in the bathroom, master bathroom. We haven't framed the shower yet. So I think that's gonna also happen soon. And then I think we're gonna order some windows soon. So we can actually start on the outside of the building. Outside is gonna be a major project, but it kind of has to be done next so that we can eventually do the insulation. We can't do insulation until we have the electrical, plumbing, and exterior finished. So there's quite a few steps that we still have to do before that. Bye.